Hey everybody, Star here. What is going on? Today we are looking at some gameplay you don't see that often. It just doesn't happen all that often. I don't do that often because it's kind of weird. It is pocketing a scout with the quick fix. And while watching this video, I came to the realization that I have heard people say many times, "Watch out, they popped Uber, watch out, they popped a crit," but I have never heard somebody say, "Watch out, they popped a quickie," or quick fix, whatever you want to call it. It's almost to the point where I don't know what to say when someone pops a quick fix because it just doesn't happen that often. You know, granted you get the quick fix Uber pretty often by how fast it charges, but you just don't see this weapon around a lot. And it is pretty fun. I'm gonna say it's not as good as the other metaguns by far because Overheal is godlike, and this whole shenanigans right here is just that, it's a shenanigan. It's a scout running around killing people with a quick fix. It's not ideal, but it's pretty fun. And one more awesome thing commonly overlooked about the quick fix is that demo man threw sticky traps on the ground. I walked right over them, went for the kill, and it didn't blast me into the air, which is great. When you're being quick fixed, you don't care about rockets hitting you in the face or anything like that. It doesn't move you. And as a scout, as any class, it lets you get into people's faces really, really easily. But especially as scout, naturally, because you're running around like a scout. As far as Ubering a scout, pocketing a scout goes, I've only done this twice. It's not something that comes up all that often that I would actually tell people, "Hey, I really need a pocket for my scout right now. I don't think I can do anything without a quick fix pocket." That's not the case, but of all the times, of the whole two times that I've tried this, it's actually gone really well, and it's a pretty effective strategy. And right here, this was actually pretty funny. I've got a whole bunch of people trying to kill me, and I don't know how I got out of here. I, like, pulled some magic out of my pockets, and it was, like, a real substance that was able to be used. So I get out of there by jumping up some boxes. This is, by the way, Croissant. I believe, no, I don't remember the version, but it is a rather new version. I'm gonna have to say offhand, Beta 9. I don't know. The last time I showed this map, it was a older version. That whole house area over there didn't exist. So worth pointing out on that. Also, it's worth pointing out right now that there is no conclusion to this match. It's not really that long of a video. I cut out some parts, like the respawn times and whatever. But nobody was really able to make a push either way as far as this video went. So there was no conclusion, and I actually remember at the very end of the video, I got like a phone call or something, and I was just like, "Oh, well, I guess I'm done recording now." And that's kind of the way things have been lately, where it's been hard to have time to play to record, it's been hard to find time to make videos in general on top of that, and once again, getting shot in the face with rockets, and forcing the pop with a quick fix. That was awesome. Anyway, yeah, have not had a lot of time to do very much lately, and also in about a week from, like, January 5th, I'm gonna be in Boston for a week, so won't be around. Hopefully I can get some uploads up while I'm gone, but no promises on that one. Anyway, that's not what's going on right now. What's going on right now is Team Fortress 2, so let's talk a little bit about that. Because right now what I'm going to be doing is, well, I don't have my medic at the moment. And, you know, granted, I could go into the battle and probably kill a few people right now without a medic. I know my medic can't do the same thing without me, and he's sort of relying on someone to be there to protect him. I mean, I can fight without a medic. A medic cannot fight without me. So I'm hanging back, I'm waiting for him to respawn, make sure I can be here when he's back. You know, granted, he can heal other people, I'm not the only option available, but I'm not so sure other people are going to stick with him. Because the way people treat medics are, "Thank you for the heal, I'm going to go do some things now, please don't follow me, I'm going to get you killed, I'm just gonna rocket jump out of your sight, and I'm done. I got my overheals," and he doesn't even have overheals, so it's not really gonna benefit that many people back there. There's a dispenser. So, the medic is the important part here. I'm not, you know, afraid of going in without the Uber, but I don't want my medic to be left alone to where he can't do anything. You always have to be thinking about what your medic has to do, and if there's someone trying to kill your medic, that is more important than them trying to kill you. You want to jump in front of your medic and take shots so your medic does not die. It is important. It's really important. You know, the medic that's healing me, I am getting quick fixed. I am being healed at a very fast rate. The medic that is healing me is not. If I can take a shot that he doesn't have to take, I'm gonna get that health back. That's not a problem. He is gonna take a lot longer to get that. And another thing, don't take health packs away from medics. They will heal you, then they take the health pack. You don't need it anymore because they're healing you. Show some respects for medics. I hear it all the time that there are too many medics in my videos where there's people always healing me, which for one thing isn't always the case. I try and make sure people don't heal me because I understand that. But a lot of people will say that, you know, having a medic with you all the time is unrealistic. It would be a little bit more realistic if you showed medics some, like, common courtesy and actually tried to protect them, because if you did that, they would continue healing you. That's just how it goes. You get one successful Kritzkrieg or Uber, and they'll say, that guy knows what he's doing, I'm having fun healing him, he knew that I wanted to Uber him, he even had voice chat. This is working out just fine. I am going to find that person. If I see him again, he is getting my next Uber, he is getting heals again, and that's just sort of the way things work out. Also, I understand as far as videos go that it's a little bit different. I have actually kicked people from my server for healing me. By the way, this engineer, he gets destroyed right in the water. I've kicked people from my server because they refused to stop healing me and pocketing me when I was playing random glasses and trying to record, and that's kind of sad. But I mean, from the medic's perspective, what kind of person would I be if I didn't let them heal me and just, you know, let the medic need someone, they need me, and I want them. I will cradle them in my arms and take care of them and make sure no harm comes their way, except I can't really do that because I'm already in a relationship, so I'm sorry, I guess I can't do that anymore. So, peace out everyone, that's all I've got for you today.